I hope you're well and having the most incredible day. As always, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new watching this video, you guys know what to do by now. Hit that subscribe button. We are on our way to 9,800 of you, which is absolutely insane, and I cannot wait to hit that. Fingers crossed we hit that this year. So if you haven't subscribed, please make sure you do. Today's video is something so incredibly exciting. I got the delivery today for the Lush Mother's Day range for 2022. Yes, I bought the whole range. The entire range is in this box and I'm so excited to open it. I've not opened it, I've not peeked. I'm so excited. So without further ado, I hope you guys enjoy this video. Grab yourselves a drink and a snack and carry on watching. So the first thing in the box is the lovely hand balm, and this is £12 for 100 grams, which I don't think is too bad considering the size. I actually thought when I bought this that the 100 gram pot was the smaller size, but it's not. So I'm actually really glad that it was this size. And ingredients wise, this one has aloe vera gel, water, almond oil, shea butter, ylang ylang oil, coconut oil, macadamia nut oil. I think that's basically it. So we're gonna open it up, give it a smell. I am so excited. Let's go. Ooh, this is really nice actually. It is super whipped, like it looks really kind of fluffy and soft. I'm gonna have to give it a try and see what it feels like on the skin, because ooh, it's such a light texture. I love that. I hate heavy hand creams, so we're gonna try this and see what it's like. That smells really nice. It's a very light floral, kind of like baby powder smell. Like, it's not overly strong in any particular fragrance. It's just very subtle, very light, very fresh. I love that. That is amazing. I am really, really impressed with that. And I absolutely love the texture. I don't know if you guys can see it very well, but it is a very kind of whipped hand cream, I suppose. It's not oily. It's not greasy. It's just a very light, soft texture. I would love a body lotion in this texture because this is the best sort of texture that I love. Should I say texture one more time? Texture. Next up, we have the Wonder Mum eye mask. Now, unfortunately, mine has come a little bit broken, but if I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I don't particularly love the eye masks. I think I had this in a Fresh and Flowers box. Did I? Let me know. I can't remember. It does look quite familiar though. But I don't particularly love the masks. I don't tend to use them as many times as I should because I use them once and I just feel a little bit like, I don't know, a little bit vulnerable when I can't see. Does anyone else feel like that? Like, I hate sleeping masks because I just feel like I can't see, and if someone like walks in my room or something, I just like can't open my eyes. Do you know what I mean? I know it's weird. But anyway, I bought this just to show you guys. This is £5. In my opinion, quite expensive, especially because these are initially made for a one use situation. I do use them about 3 times or so because I think that paying £3 to £5 for something to use once is a little bit on the pricey side. However, I did buy it for this video. So this is what it looks like. It's a beautiful gold color with a red star, kind of like Wonder Woman. And ingredients wise, we have got fennel seed and saffron infusion, fresh aloe gel, carrageenan extract, and fresh carrot juice. I think I have had this before, or it's going to be very similar to the star ones that we had before, but I'm dreading it because I absolutely hate the smell of saffron, which I've come to realize over the past few months that saffron is not my favorite smell. But we're going to open it and we're going to smell it anyway because I feel like I just need to smell it. Do you know what I mean? Yes, so this smells exactly like the stars that we had. Saffrony, not my fave, but I'm glad I bought it, obviously, to share with you guys what it's like. Would I recommend the eye masks? I don't think I would. I think they're very nice if you're gonna buy them for somebody else, like in a pamper package or something. Great idea, but I would never really buy these for myself because I just don't find them necessary. Do you know what I mean? I much prefer the little sheet ones that go kind of under the eyes. But yeah, I like the concept. I love the idea, just not my favorite product, if I'm gonna be honest. The next item is one which I'm probably the most excited for, and that is the Yummy Custard Body Wash. Now, I heard that this smells like Let the Good Times Roll, which I'm very excited about if it does, and I had to get a pot. I only bought the 100 gram pot though, as you guys know, because I do all of these collection hauls, I don't need big pots of stuff. But past Melody, when I worked there, I definitely would have bought the large one, probably a few pots of it as well. So let's open it up and give it a smell, and then we'll go through the ingredients and see what's inside. Oh, it looks nice. Oh, it does smell like Let the Good Times Roll. I love Let the Good Times Roll. It's so underrated, actually. I think the Lush cleansers, the fresh ones, are becoming one of my favourite things, especially from the Fresh and Flowers boxes. I'm loving trying them all, but Let the Good Times Roll is such a good cleanser. And that smells incredible. It basically smells like food. It smells like, it's hard to describe it, popcorn-y, caramelly, buttery, that kind of smell. Ingredients-wise, it has got vanilla oat milk, aloe vera gel, cornstarch, vanilla pod powder, and gardenia extract. It's a very similar texture to the Posh Chocolate Body Wash, so I'm really excited to give this a go because I love that. And the smell of this is like next level delish. So if you haven't tried this or you want to try it and you haven't bought it yet, go in the store and try it because it smells incredible. If you love foodie smells, you'll love this. I also forgot to say that this is £8 for the 100 gram pot. I thought I said about it, but I don't think I did. So it's £8, not overly expensive. I mean, it is expensive in the grand scheme of things, but for a Lush product, definitely worth it in my opinion. I'm so excited to use that. So the next item is a bath bomb, and that is the Jasmine bath bomb. This one is £4.50, and we did have a bubble bar very, very similar to this last year, which was really nice. I really loved it. Let's smell it. Oh, this smells so good. It smells like the Flowering Tea Bubble Bar. Do you guys remember that? Because that was one of my absolute favourite products when I worked there, and I bought loads of those. I think I still have some, not really shocked, but I loved them. It's a very clean, like, Nan's bathroom kind of smell, like, clean and fresh, you know? A little bit floral, not overpowering, not too in your face. Really, really delicious. I love that. So ingredients-wise for this one, it has ylang ylang oil, water, tapioca pearl, and jasmine absolute. Just makes me want to have a bubble tea, you know, with the tapioca. Oh, love that. Smells amazing. Looks beautiful. Moving on. The next item is the shower gel for this range, and that is the Mimosa shower gel. Again, I only bought a small one because I just feel like I want to try it. I don't necessarily need to buy giant bottles of shower gel anymore. I need to get through all the ones that I have. So I bought a tiny bottle. So price-wise for the 120 gram bottle, it is £7. And then you have the 290 gram bottle, which is £14. And then you can get the 555 gram bottle, which is £23. So I just got a small one for this one. And ingredients wise we have got fresh orange juice, wine lees oil, Mimosa absolute, sweet wild orange oil, carnation absolute. Let's give it a smell and see what it smells like. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this smells exactly like Celebrate and bubbly. Oh, so good. That went on my nose. I really, really like the smell of this. To me, it smells like Celebrate, bubbly. It's a very orangey, zingy, fresh shower gel. 10 out of 10. Would highly recommend it if you want to get a new shower gel. You will really like this, especially if you like those fruity, zingy scents. Delicious. The next item is the soap for Mother's Day, and that is the Buzzy Mum soap. How cute is this? This is the cutest soap I think I have ever seen. It's a little tiny bumblebee, like, I can't cope with it. So cute. Oh, that smells really good. This smells, oh wait, this has layers. Like, it smells fruity, then like floral. It smells, wait, I just need to connect my thoughts. And like, to me it smells like, it's got like an underlayer of like snow cake soap mixed with like a bit of bubbly shower gel on top, you know? That's unreal. Oh, I love the smell of that. Price-wise, this is £6, and ingredients-wise, this one has got rapeseed oil, coconut oil, Mimosa Absolute Sweet Wild Orange Oil, peach powder, and coconut oil and gardenia extract. So it is that Mimosa oil that smells like bubbly to me, but I'm definitely getting like a snow cake vibe underneath. That's delicious. And if that isn't the cutest soap you've ever seen, honestly, amazing. The next item is the Atom Heart Mother Bath Bomb. This one is another repeat from last year, and from what I remember, I really liked this one. This one, price-wise, is £5. I do think that Lush Bath Bombs are getting more and more expensive, because to me, £5 is quite a lot. I feel like when I worked there, this would have been, like, definitely a £3.95-er. Do you know what I mean? Oh, smells so good. What is that smell? I've smelled that before. Oh, it's gonna annoy me. What smell is that? That is definitely a Lush fragrance we've had before, 100%. Can I remember what it is? No. So if you know what this smells like, please, I am begging you, let me know in the comments, because you guys have very good knowledge of Lush scents and what have been like used again. And when I'm in the moment and I'm filming a video, my brain turns into mashed potato and I can't remember anything. But that is delish. It's like fresh, gardeny, but nice. really yummy. Okay, let's go and see what the ingredients are. So ingredients wise, we have got bergamot oil, Brazilian orange oil, rose absolute, orange flower absolute, and neroli oil. That's delish. Oh, so good. Incredibly fresh, not overpowering, and it's just so cute. I love the clouds on it. I think it's absolutely adorable. Very like Toy Story vibes. I love it. So cute. The next bath bomb again is another return, and that is the rose gold bath bomb. This bath bomb is so beautiful. It has the most intricate like prints on it. There's just flowers all over it, and I love the design of that. And it is covered in gold glitter, which is all over my bed, all over my lap, and all over my hands. But never mind, let's give it a smell, see what she smells like. Very good. Oh, so nice. What is that? So price wise this one is £6 as well. And ingredients wise we have got ylang ylang oil, bergamot oil, orris root powder, and then loads of other bits and pieces that I cannot pronounce. But this one just smells very floral, but not a strong floral by any means. It's a very subtle, it's hard to describe it. It's like a subtle but strong smell. It's got like a very powdery smell to it, but it's got a floral like note, and I'm getting glitter everywhere. I need to put this down, but I don't want to put it on my bed. I have to put it back there. And my hands are covered in sparkles, but I really like that. Smells amazing, looks beautiful, and I think it goes orange in the water, so I'm excited to use that one. The next item is again another bath bomb, and that is the Elephant in the Tea Room bath bomb. So this is really cute because one side is pink, one side is blue, and I love that. It reminds me of the fluffy egg for Easter. And this one was £6, but it's really weighty. Like, I will give it credit. Like, it is a very heavy bath bomb. And before I smell it, I will go through the ingredients. So this one has bergamot oil, lemon myrtle oil, benzoin resinoid, soybean flour, powdered gunpowder tea. What is even in that? I don't even know. We also have organic tea powder. So let's give it a smell. Is it gonna smell like tea? What is that? Oh my god, wait, this is a smell. Obviously this is a previous Lush smell. It's like a mix of like, how do I describe it? It's got a mix of smells, almost like what's the sweets called? Fruit salads mixed with like a blackjack. That's so good. That's unbelievable. That smells. Oh yeah, 10 out of 10. I love that, and I love that it's pink and blue. Delish. And last but not least for the Mother's Day range of 2022 is the Besties Bubble Bar. So cute. How cute is this? It's two little giraffes and they're cuddling, and I love giraffes so much, and this is so cute. This is £6, and ingredients wise we have got cream of tartar, cornstarch, Brazilian orange oil, lime oil, glycerin, water, titanium dioxide, blah 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 blah. Let's give it a smell. Oh, to me this smells like Golden Wonder. Is it Golden Wonder? Somebody let me know. Like the Celebrate Bubbly, that smells delish. I would eat that. I won't, but I want to. That's so yummy. Wow, okay, I absolutely love that. And for £6, bargain, because I think you could probably get like two, maybe three good baths out of that. Plus it's so cute. I love it. Oh, Lush, 10 out of 10. Yum. So that is everything for the Mother's Day range of 2022. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video, and let me know in the comments if you are going to be buying anything from the range, what you loved, what you didn't like, what you wanted to see more of. I would love to know the comments, and I'm always replying to comments as much and as often as I can. So please leave me a comment down below. And obviously, if you haven't already, please make sure you subscribe to my channel. If you don't know already, I have a current giveaway going on right now. If you haven't entered, make sure you do, because I would love to give that gift away. So if you haven't subscribed and you haven't entered, please do so. But that is everything. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you very soon. Bye, guys.